Hi everyone, this is Zikima and Dango here. So today we are going to do an interview on one of the best players in Apex Arena in Langrisser Mobile, which is Zikima. And Zikima is known as one of the best metro players. So he really plays the game like metro. Like it's just a lot of like assassins, like a lot of rush. And he's one of the best players who use this strategy. So hi, Zikima, are you ready for the interview?
Yeah, I'm ready. Hello, Dango. Hello, guys.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm very excited to have you here. So let me just start with some of the like very basic questions. So my first question will be, what is the reason that you joined the Langrisser Mobile?
Since I love strategy, games, mm-hmm. and I was playing many games in my past, and I mainly was playing on the console games like PS6, PS1, PS2, so this is like my story started from this strategy RPG games, mm-hmm. and when I was playing this I started like it, but I never played mobile games. And in my past I was playing, I don't know if you ever heard like Epic 7 Fire Emblem.
Yeah, I heard these games. Also, I played a little bit of both games as well. But I kind of quit Epic 7 pretty soon because I found the developer, they kind of like want the player to buy a lot of packs. So I was a little bit pissed on that and I quit immediately.
Yeah, it was kind of same story like me, you know, and it was my first experience because it was gacha games, like yes. We have Langrisser now.
Yeah.
But it's like I was saying, like this was my start from these games, and I start research upcoming new games for this year, 2019. So and I found this game and I was like, oh, it's really curious. And it's like even this how the characters looks, units and this strategy, like you need count the squares, like move the squares. For me it's like really because and I forgot to tell you, like the most beautiful game for me was Final Fantasy Tactics from on console. You probably heard about this.
Okay, I never heard about that one actually.
Oh, okay, it's fine. But yeah, this is like how it started, and I found this game, and now I just like it.
Okay, yeah. So actually, the design of the character actually have a very strong impression on you when you like deciding which game to play. That's kind of interesting. Yeah, some feedback we can provide to Zilong for sure. And so far that you have been playing this game for, like very long. You are in the first server in this game, so I'm guessing you started the game like at the very beginning, right?
Yeah, very beginning when many people was re-rolling accounts. Mm-hmm. I did this too. I started with sadly with Bozo. I mean, in that
why
time,
why are you sad with Bozo? Bozo is strong.
I mean, yeah, he is strong. I said sadly because in later he was.
Free character, yeah.
So when I heard this, like you would be free, I said, oh yeah, and my rolling count was for nothing.
Okay, yeah, that's not a big problem. Okay, yeah, so that's pretty funny. So far that you have been playing this long time, which part you like the most in this game and why?
When I start this language, mostly because of the strategy games. I mean, mm-hmm. like you play these missions, events, yeah. But after that, I find out there will be PvP content as well. Mm-hmm. I said, wow, this is like for me, I always enjoy this kind of times, but this time you can play with the players.
Yes.
And yeah, in Fire Emblem, I don't remember if it was a PvP.
So there was a PvP. There was a PvA, or you know, like you are playing against. It's basically like the auto arena that we have in Langrisser Mobile. Yeah. So it was a pretty shitty.
Yeah. Auto arena was fine, but like it's not long term. I really like lose the joy. But when I started to play with the players, like this was for me really joy. So yeah, now for your question, PvP is like for me that, to be honest, and even keep me playing, because if there will be no PvP, I'll probably skip this game. I'm honest.
Yeah, so actually that's very similar to me. Like, for like the content I really enjoy is like PvP. So for like PvE for me is more like a grinding for better PvP experience. Like, so yeah, so I don't really enjoy like temples or, you know, all these crazy like gym runs. Maybe some of the story mode, you know, some of the time rift I feel pretty interesting as well. But yeah, mostly I think the reason that I keep me playing in this game is actually PvP, especially like when they released the Apex Arena, which introduced such a complex and integrated PvP system. I was very, very happy, and yeah, that's really the best PvP system I have, you know, I have ever seen in a mobile game. This is, yeah, one of the reasons also keep me in this game. Yeah, I'm glad that I hear you also enjoy this content a lot.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, I like PvE too, but like it's like one way, one goal, you know, like,
yes.
Okay, I clear it and that's it, you know?
Yes, exactly. You this probably explains the my next question. You know, I have met you in Apex Arena and the World Arena a lot, you know, from time to time. So yeah, so I mean, definitely because you enjoy it, I enjoy it too, so we meet a lot. So so far, how many Apex Arena battle you have played in this season, not including the playoff?
Yeah, from what I remember, it was something like 250, 260.
Yeah, actually, you have a very similar amount of battle compared to me. I think I probably didn't jump to like 260, but I'm definitely above 200. I think I'm like 220-ish. Yeah, well, that's a ton of games. Yeah, definitely you enjoy it.
I saw some people have even 300 plus. So I was playing Sundays every Sunday, and sometimes when I have a time Saturdays. But I was playing at least two sessions, so like because there are three sessions.
Yeah. So yeah, this is like I think lots of players like really really enjoy this mode. So yeah, so like with all this like amount of game that you played during the regular season, do you think like those like kind of like practice helped you improve your skills and understanding of the PvP system, like especially Apex Arena in this game?
Oh yeah, I mean, I make huge amount of mistakes in this when playing the Apex, even if I hit the Langrisser and they'll have this one. It's like I knew it that 1,900 points would be enough to qualify for this playoff. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I was practicing every weekend. So
yeah.
And I think the mistakes that we can take it, they are the best teacher, you know, like.
Yes.
So yeah,
yes.
Definitely I can, you know, say that, yeah, this was like, for me, best teacher.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So actually for me, like sometimes like we have like four season, we have three or four, I forget, three or four time slot in the Apex Arena. And you know, some players, they are complaining, you know, they cut off the playing time. So actually to me, I mean, I still don't like the cut off the time, but it just happens to provide me a time to actually let me reveal the game that I lost. So, you know, after like the second time period and there was a like break, so I just go back to the first two slots and I check how I lost. For example, I lost to you or lost to like Lemons, lost to Roy Lee. I check, you know, is there a like problem from the pick and ban? Did I make some stupid mistake from there? So yeah, I agree with you. Like basically loss is the best teacher for you. Like you improve a little bit after you lose, and I remember like the experience with you is very clearly. Like I think for example at the beginning you don't really know like about summon strategy, and you had a lot of problem with like if I am using summon strategy against you, I will have a lot of advantage. And then at the later part of the season, I started to realize you started also use the summon strategy. And you can, like, from the pick ban, you actually try to prevent others to, you know, use summon strategy against you. So, yeah, is that something you learned from, like, maybe just one small thing you learned from the, like, practice?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you give me the example with the summon skill, and yes, like I still remember when I was playing first time with you, with yours, that you surprised me, and I didn't know how to react to this.
Yeah.
I was like, this changing turns, and yeah,
yes.
After a second, third time, I was like, oh, okay, I know how to deal with it.
Yes, yes, exactly. Yeah. So yeah, I totally agree with you. Like, I think like even like some players, they just stopped after reaching Langrisser. But you know, the skill is still like so different, and with like new characters coming, with the release of Iris, with like Sakura, yeah, like lots of things are changing. So you really like, if you want to stay, you know, stay like top level in Apex Arena, you really need to kind of like practice, you know, especially I mean, if you are not doing Apex Arena over the weekends, at least you should practice with your friends. So yeah, that's always a good way to keep you like stay fresh. And so
I strongly recommend to everyone at least like choose one Saturday or Sunday and at least one session, like train every week. It's like strong. It's really good training, really good training.
Yeah. And you know, we have been like discussing with the developers. We hope they can make like a better seeding system so that it can encourage more people, you know, more players to play. So for example, if you make it like the top 64, then maybe you can get a better seeding. So, you know, you don't have to face the top 10 player or top 16 players or such things. Yeah, it's just a small things. Maybe they can also incent like players to try a little bit. This is also, for the good of these players so that they can keep learning, so they can have the, you know, still have the updated skills. Yeah, so yeah, that's about this part. And so for this season, did you set any goal, and did you think you achieved your goal?
Yeah, I mean, I reached my goal, definitely, because, I mean, it was a small goal, because I set up for, like, it would be sad if I would lose the first round in the playoff.
Yeah,
I had first round, not like perfect match, but it was smooth. Second one was too smooth. So yeah, I reached my goal.
So yes, Zikama, I see like the first two rounds of Apex Arena battle. Yeah, it is actually pretty smooth. So yeah, and I think you had a like pretty like strong pick and ban, and you have constructed your strategy well. You know, you have a very strong like Leonhard and Sakura.
Yeah, I mean, that's mostly many players that are not familiar with Sakura. So yeah, my two fights was mostly on the Sakura and Leonhard. Unfortunately, my third round didn't go well, but I reached my goal.
Yeah, so you reached your goal. Yeah, so for the third battle, actually, I just have a small question. So yeah, it looks like your strategy actually changed a little bit. Like, you were picking characters like Leonhard or Sakura at the first few picks for the first couple rounds. But in the third round, you go back to your original scale that you first picked the Zareda. Is there anything?
Because mostly I have a choice, go with the Leonhard or with the Zareda. It's like you probably know me from my Meteor strategy. Like, I'm really fan of Zareda.
Yes,
I know the her days will be they are counted, like she will be not so strong later on, but in season one she's still pretty strong, and you have to watch out for her.
So the game three, I just discussed a little bit the game three. It looks like you still have like a chance to win the battle from the record. It's a little bit sad that maybe there was like small mistake that you made. Zikma, you definitely like have been like awesome. Like this season you stayed at like top 64. So this is already, I would say, a pretty good goal, a very good achievement for you. So you know, season two like is coming in a month. So you will still be able to, you know, enjoy the game and show your strengths in season two. Yeah, so hopefully, like season two, you will come back and push it a little further. Yeah, so good luck.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully, in the first round, I will not get lemons or Roy, you know.
Yeah, let's hope so. Yeah, this is something we have been discussing, like if we can have a, you know, a seeding system to make sure if you are like top 16, you're top like 32 or top 64, these people should be, you know, these people should not face like top 16 players like in the first round. So yeah, this is something we have been discussing. So hopefully they can listen to us, and then yeah, the group will be better and you will have relatively easier battle in your first and second round. Yeah. So yeah, so actually, yeah, I think maybe this is not because the question would be super straightforward, and for you, I probably already know the answer, but I'm still going to ask. So like we have a couple of strategy in season one, naming like rush strategy, like summon strategy, like tank push strategy, or like stall strategy. So of all these like different strategies, which type is your favorite?
I think I was surprised because none of them. I mean, maybe mm-hmm. kind of like rush and mm-hmm. I could say DPS team or something like this. I'm really fan of like, I'm yeah. totally not fan of this dark team. Like I call it turtle team. But yeah, this is like definitely not my style. And yeah, healers. Yeah, we need them. In season two, I will see, but I will be testing. Definitely DPS team, like even yeah. no healer, no tank, no healer, no tanks. And this will be for me not good because I heard you will not know the name from the pick and ban. But if somebody yes. will see that there is no heal and no tank, they will obviously see, oh, he's a Zakima.
Yes, exactly. So yeah, you will get some disadvantage from the box. Yeah, but the other thing for season two that you should watch out is like, you know, the characters are getting very bigger. It is very hard. So yeah, lots of the time it is going to be hard for your attackers to one-shot anybody. So this is why in season two, I mean, at least in Chinese server, like tank push strategy is the best strategy. I mean, summon is not exist anymore. Rush is hard because you cannot one shot. Yeah. And if you have like five attackers, well, to be honest, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know exactly. Yeah, but
I mean, mostly because you see, when you go with the tanks team, your other units need to keep around the tanks. So yes. of course, I will be try AOE mm-hmm. units, mm-hmm. but we'll see. I will be testing definitely. If not, I will come back to this star.
Yeah, I'm super I'm super looking forward to how will you play in season two, because you know, it looks like at the current meta change. I mean, it will affect my style a little bit because I use summon, but it may also affect your style a little bit because you never use a tank. Like from the Chinese server, it looks like it's pretty hard to play this game without a tank in season 2. But yes, we will definitely see like if you can find some like better ways to like manipulate this situation. Yeah, it's going to be, yeah, I think it's going to be like very interesting to test this in season 2.
Yeah, and I'll be like surprise. Not sure if I will be surprised. So much risky in this playoffs, but we will see.
yeah okay, yeah, so we are definitely like looking forward to season two. Yeah, and for like all these you know, season one Apex Arena, including the playoff seasons, like do you have like some particular battle that you just had the most impression that you can't forget the battle that you get very super excited?
You know, when you mention, you can forget definitely around three playoffs. I lost, but
yeah,
this I will never forget with this mess skill on Zerida. But yeah, from the battles that you mentioned, I think I most learned it from you. I still even remember this battle, like I went with Leonhard and mm-hmm. you went with Zerida and Wheeler. You know, like,
yeah,
I didn't know his skill properly.
Yeah.
And I used
yeah.
this
button. Yeah. There was a battle. Yeah. Like I was using Zerida and you was like, oh, what Villa can again
yeah,
for Rida.
What he was doing, I will get him next to in Leonhardt, you know.
So Villa is going to be pretty interesting character. I'm not sure in season two, but you know, he has a very interesting like three cost scale coming in season three. So we will see if Villa is going to be like a very interesting character later.
Because for people to understand the situation, because you're really the cast as Alhazard, so you lose your troops, but Wheeler cast his skill that give him a turn again. So that's why you kill.
This is a very like surprise skill, because very little of the population in global server are using Wheeler. I think besides me, only, you know, especially if you think about like the top like 50 players, I really don't remember if I see others using Villa. Maybe like Manson was using, because Manson, you know, Manson is one of my friends, so his style is like sometimes very similar to my style, so he's also using Villa. But besides that, I really can't think of anyone who's using Villa in like the top 50 like players. So in that battle, I was definitely taking advantage of something that you didn't know before. So you learned it. So that's good.
I'm pretty sure in season two there will be more fans of this.
Especially with the release of lots of like new characters. You know, next banner we will have the long-awaited Yulia coming to global server. And then we will have two of the UU Hexo banner, which will introduce four of the characters. And to be honest, only two of the characters are popular in Chinese server, but I do think the other two characters also have their potential in this game. We will see if some of the players can take good use of these characters and really surprise us in season two. I'm super like looking forward to it.
So
this is pretty much all the like interview for today. So thank you very much for Zikma for like joining this interview, and let all these other players to have a chance to to know your playstyle and know how you think about this Langrisser mobile game, and especially how you think and how you play the Apex Arena. This is a very, I think, a very good interview with you. Thank you very much, Sigma.
Yeah, thanks a lot, too. And thanks for your time. I appreciate it. Thanks.
And thanks, guys, for watching this video. And I hope you find this useful and interesting. So, I will see you guys in my next interview. Next interview is going to be interview with Natural. So see you guys later. Bye. Peace.